So let's try this. I would put all of this functionality in a method. Give me a minute to arrange that, and then I'll show you. As promised, here is my method. This method keeps reading an integer until it finds one that is within the desired range, and then it returns it. The exact code isn't really important right now. You can have a look at it in the code distribution if you want to. And now here, I'm calling it. But there's a problem. When I compile it, I get an error message. And that error message right now must surely appear like gibberish to you, where it talks about non-static methods and static methods. So let me explain what's happening here and why the compiler is unhappy. Normally, we call a method on an object. And I didn't do that here because I figured, well, I'm in elevator demo, so I should be able to call any elevator demo method as well. But the trouble is I'm calling from main. So there are no elevator demo objects, and the compiler complains. So going back here, that is the crux of the problem. Read between is not called on an object, and there really isn't a great object to call it on. It would have been nice to call it on the scanner, but like I already said, we can't do that. Whenever you're in this kind of situation where you have a method that can't really be called on an object, then you make a static method. A static method is a method that's not called on any object. So one remedy is simply to go back into elevator demo and declare the helper method static, like this. Now all will be well, and the syntax error is gone. So to answer our original question, it's perfectly legitimate to put read between into elevator demo as a static method, but maybe it's not optimal, because what if I want to use that perfectly nifty method in another class? So really, read between is a method that seems it would be useful in any situation that you want to read a value from some range. So we might really want to put this somewhere else. And the class that I'm going to put it on, I'll call IOHelper. I've prepared that class for you. Let me show you. Here is the IOHelper class. Here is the readBetween method. And again, it's a static method because I'm not going to actually make any objects of the IOHelper class. I just want it to be the home for this method. That means when I call the method, I have to specify the name of the class like this. Here you see the name of the class, IOHelper, the name of the method. Static methods are not incredibly common because, like I said, most of the time an actual object is responsible for carrying out a method. But they do happen. In fact, you've seen a few of them. In lesson 4, you saw a good number of static methods in the math class. Again, the syntax is the name of the class, a period, and then the name of the method. And once again, there is no object of the math class. We simply call the squareRoot method directly on the class. Now you may wonder, why did we have to use a static method? Why couldn't we just call the method on the number 2? Well, that's what it's like in Java. In Java, numbers are not objects, so you can never call a method on an object. A call such as 2.squareRoot might be more logical, but it's an error. So to summarize, a static method belongs to a class. It's not called on an object. And they're not actually all that common. Why do you call them static methods? There's no good reason, actually. That's a holdover from another much more ancient programming language. There's nothing particularly static about them. In addition to static methods, there are static variables. Let's have a look at them next.